So we have it. Sorry. Regular language L, then we can have some finite automation, or we can say finite state machine. Right? Whose finite state machine will accept this language L, and we call that machine like L of M. That means M is a machine which accepts the language L. Now, it does not say that whether it is deterministic or non-deterministic. So that means what? That a regular language can be accepted by a deterministic finite state machine or a non-deterministic finite state machine, or by a DFA, deterministic finite automata, or NFA, non-deterministic finite automata, right? So if a language L is accepted by, say, both, you know, there is one DFA which is accepting L, and there is on NFA which is also accepting the same L, language L. So that means what? That means, okay, this NFA, you do write M dash. Okay, so that means what? That means this machine and this machine, M and M dash, are equivalent, because both of them are capable to accept same language L. So from here, we got a concept that whether we can convert NFA to DFA. Can we convert? Because, you know, why don't we speak about converting a DFA to NFA? Reason is that DFAs are nothing but a kind of NFA, right? It satisfied a certain property we call that it is a DFA, right? So concern is, if you have a NFA, whether we can convert that NFA to DFA or not. Okay, so here you can see we have an NFA here which is accepting some language. If you see here, this language is A from Q0, if it be A, it is going to Q1. Then Q1 can consume any number of A, so A star. Okay, so A star can be a language, one kind of, you know, can say strings which are accepted by this language. And again, if you have something A star, then B, then again A star. Okay, and this part can repeat, right? Can repeat for any number of time. So this can be a language which is, we can say, acceptable by this NFA, right? If this star is going to be zero, sorry, just changing the whole thing. If this star is going to be, you know, zero time iterating, then it is going to give you only A star. So A star is also accepted. So we don't need to write this separately. This can be the language which is accepted by this. Okay. Now, it means what? It means one thing, that this language does not start with B. Right? It can't be start with B, is not accepted. Okay? No, if we think about DFA, M dash, corresponding to this NFA M, then on the starting state itself, if we get the first symbol is B, we can send to trap state, right? It is never be accepted. Okay, but if we get E star, we send to some accepted state, and again after getting A star, if you get again a B and A and any number of A repeating, then you can say again that is going to be accepted, right? So that we have facilitated here. Okay, so I can say that this is a DFA equivalent to this NFA, correct? So step-by-step conversion of NFA to DFA, what we have learned previously. First, let's have a brush off on that part. So we was knowing that one thing, that the starting state of the NFA will be simply become the starting state of the DFA. Then if there is some states which are reachable by giving empty symbol lambda, or sometimes write epsilon, then we can merge these states. So we have q1 and q2. From q1 to q2 we can reach by giving lambda, so we can merge them together and we can create one single state. And out of these, and you say that after merging, what set you are getting? Set of state. If one of them or one element is final state, so here you can see that one element is there, that is q1 state, which is a final state, then if we have a final state, then we should make this new state as a final state. That is what we have done. Okay, then if from q0 in the NFA, from q0 for A we have an outgoing path, but for B there is nothing, but in DFA we have a rule that for every input symbol, we have a transition, right? So here from Q0 we have to generate a transition for B. Here it is not there, but in DFA we have to add it. So we added a transition for B, which is taking us to some trap state. Okay, as this state is not there in the NFA, we simply, for any symbol, if there is no path defined in the NFA, when we are going to build the DFA, we send those transitions to some phi state. Okay, then you can see this for Q1, our headache is finished, or you can say our headache is ended. Because from Q1 we have two transition for A and B both. Now our headache should be adding the transition for this state. So you can see Q1 had a self loop for A, which we can simply add with this state. Okay, so that is added here. So this state in DFA got one transition, which is for A, but for another transition for B we have to add. So that we have added. See, for B previously we had a transition from Q2 to Q0, but here Q2 is here, so this transition we add from Q2 to Q0 like this for this B. Okay, and nothing else is left to call this one as a DFA. This is already become a DFA. Only thing is left is we have a state which is not defined, that what will be the transition for A or B. So that transition we can add here like this. Okay, so it is fully DFA. We can say we have converted this NFA to DFA. So convert NFA M to an equivalent DFA M dash, where M dash L of M is equal to L of M dash. Okay, so if NFA has states like, you know, this Q1, Q2, Q, and so on, the DFA has states in the power set. Power set of what? Of this. That is what? Q of the NFA, right? It is power set of Q. So it can have 5, it can have, you know, Q0, you can have Q1, you can have any combination of these elements, what we have here. You can have any combination or, you know, any subset of this set or all possible subsets of this Q set here, and that will be called as power set. Okay, so yeah, it is the same thing. You can see on this only thing is that the rules are written here. This Q0 is added, the first rule is the initial state of NFA is the initial state of DFA again. Okay, then for every DFA state, you know, compute in NFA, that is delta star QIA union delta star QJA, you can just make a single transition like this. It has happened because, you know, by giving basically, you should write here, you know, if there is a lambda transition. Okay, so this part we already know it from our previous study of theory of computation. Okay, so I'm not going to discuss this further again, because I have already told you how it is going to be converted. But this is not the final thing. This is not the only method we can do. What is the problem with this method? You know, this algorithm, if you see these things, these steps, they are quite intuition based. We need to observe our NFA very carefully, and looking at that, based on that observation, we generate this DFA, right? So this is how we do in this method. But if you want to automate the system, that means if we'll give your system an input, your input is this NFA, and there will be a program which will convert. So program which will convert this NFA to DFA. Then this algorithm is becomes less fruitful or less useful for this kind of task. So for that situation, we need some new algorithm. That algorithm we will go through today. Okay. So here is the thing that prove that M equal to LM dash. So we assume, if how we can prove. If we can prove that LM is a subset of LM dash, and on the other hand, you can also show that LM dash is a subset of LM, then take a random string W that belongs to L, prove it by induction. So this is not an important part for this paper. This was important part for your computation paper. Okay, so I'm not going into this in further detail. Yes, so another thing, and a number of times it comes into our mind, that is single final state for NFA. So what happens in NFA, we will find that there is many final state, but we can convert these many final state to a single final state. How we can do it? It is quite simple. You can see here in this NFA we have two final state, Q1 and Q3. Simply, you don't make them final state. you just add another final state q4, and using empty input, you can just add all these transition from the old final state to the new final state, which and then you can have a single final state in NFA. Okay, but doing this thing in DFA is very hard. But for NFA, this is another good thing. You can convert the NFA to a single final state. This is the extreme case that if you say that, is it possible that a DFA without a final state? So we don't like to have such a thing, but if you really have that situation, you must have a final state, which is like an island state, which will